Learn how to quickly renew or revoke Azure function keys in this edition of Azure Tips and Tricks. When working with HTTP triggers with Azure Functions, you actually be provided with a set of keys that you could use to authorize who can and can't access your function. Here inside of the manage section of my function, you can see I have function keys and I also have host keys. If I click on these keys, I can see the value that I need to provide my function if I want to execute it. I'm going to go over here to my hello function and I'm going to click on get function URL. I'm going to copy that. Now I'm going to switch over to Postman. I'm going to paste that value in there. Notice that there's a code parameter that's passed in the URL. This is actually the function key that I'm using. Notice that it actually returns a response from my function. If I were supposed to remove this, now here on the right side, you'll see we're actually getting a 401 on authorize. So my function wasn't executing. So I need that function key to execute my function. Now, what if I needed to revoke it, or if I wanted to remove it altogether? Here on the right side, under the manage section, I can click renew or revoke. If I wanted to renew my function key, or if I just wanted to remove it altogether. So I'm going to click on renew. And notice that I get a different function key. Let's hit renew again, just for good measure. Again, notice that I'm getting a completely different function key. Back inside of my Azure function, if I click get function URL again, notice that it's providing my function key. I'll head back to Postman. I'm going to try that request we did before with the old key. Notice that it's still saying 401 unauthorized. Now I'm going to try my function again with the new key. And there you see, I was able to execute my function after I revoked the old function key, and I was able to use a new one.